Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. This is going to be a super quick video. It's going to show you how to change the language settings in Google. But not only that, I want to show you what the impact of that is, because it actually has quite a big impact on a lot of things. So for example, all the interfaces will change. So too will the way that Google searches for you. So too will the videos that are recommended to you on YouTube. So I'm going to take you through this super quick video. Really hope you like it. If you do, please like it. Please share it with other teachers and students. And of course, please comment on the video. Let's get started. So I'm already logged in to my Gmail account. I'm already logged into Google. I click here and I click on manage your Google account. Click on manage your Google account. And the one you want to come to is privacy and personalization. Click here. And then where you want to come is to scroll down and come down to your language preferences. Now I'm going to show you this because it's really interesting what happens immediately. So I'm going to click here and I'm going to edit my current choice and I'm going to change it to Spanish. So I'm going to put it, you always search in your in the actual language name. So in Spanish it's Espanol. So I choose Espanol. And then I do need to choose the country that I'm associating with that as well. So I'm going to say España. And now if I click select, you'll notice suddenly everything updates. And now all of the information on the screen is actually in Spanish. So you can make that change anytime you want. And that therefore means that if you want to be working in a different language, now that will influence other things that happen on Google as well. And let me just give you one example. Now, what a lot of people don't realize is that this actually has an impact on lots of other things. For example, I've just come back to Google now. Notice that everything is in Spanish. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to do a Google search. Okay. And I'm going to search for something generic. In other words, I'm going to put the word in Euro 2021, which is related to the European football competition that's taking place. Now, even though that word could be interpreted in English or in Spanish, for example, the returns that are sent to me for that search now are all in Spanish because I have put Spanish as my language. And this therefore is really important to understand, including, look at this, all of the returns from YouTube, etc., are all impacted by you making that change to the language that you want to work with. So this could be great for language learners. If you want to get used to working in a particular language, then perhaps, for example, in my case, I'm learning Polish, it would be a good idea to change the language to Polish, and therefore all of the language on Google will be in Polish. Now, as a final thing, I've just jumped over to YouTube and you'll notice actually that it's still sharing some content in English and yet it's also now sharing some content in Spanish. Now, the reason for that is simply this. Remember, Google has your search history. So if you were previously searching in English and you changed to Spanish, in your YouTube, it's still going to recommend the popular videos that you've been watching in English previously. It will still recommend them to you. The only way to completely switch to Spanish now would be to delete the history. If you deleted the history, then it would start from scratch. It would only know what language you want to work in and it would recommend everything in Spanish. But you will notice that as soon as you change over to another language, you do begin to get some recommendations in that new language. And notice here at the top, for example, that it's tried to encourage me to go to various sections and those are in Spanish. So it will have an impact on YouTube, but not completely, simply because the videos that are recommended to you on YouTube will depend on your previous viewing history. I really hope that video is useful. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Loads more free videos, different technologies here at the top. But we've also got these special sections. One that's particularly interesting is digital skills, learning to use Google more effectively, as well as YouTube, as well as Google Forms, making websites, etc. These are key skills that teachers and students need. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the latest blogs, the webinars, the online courses, as well as the new videos that I upload. You can, of course, follow me on my YouTube channel. If you subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell to get the updates. And finally, if you did want to contact me about doing any training with me, you can do that from the website. Click on Contact Russell, and obviously I train online as well as visiting organizations to do the training directly. Thank you very much.